Excuse me, you're 5 months so far in the house. What have you done particularly to address these problems that you say need to be fixed?
Well, I mean, we've passed several bills, both spending reductions, government reductions, health care, and they've gone to the Senate. They're just sitting there. I mean, that's the challenge. One of the big things that we've done to create jobs and create energy is the trade effort that we put forward. Again, we're in 30 days, we're going to have a new trade agreement with Panama, Korea, and Colombia, something that 5 months ago they didn't anticipate happening. So again, this the bigger issue, of course, is we've got to get our country working, we've got to get back on track, and to do this, this culture in D.C. needs to change. It's broken.
This is somewhat of a re-announcement, having announced yesterday through a video release. How important is the social media going to be in a campaign like this for you?
Well, again, we want to get the message out however we can. Here's the problem. What I've realized in the first 5 months is until the American people understand clearly and are communicating that message to their elected representatives, it's going to be hard to get change in Washington. So it's critical, whether it's a social media or however we get the message out, that people understand the challenge that we're facing and the important steps that we need to take to get the country back on track.
Is that why you're announcing so soon?
Yeah, I mean, again, part of this process is we have to get the message out. This is not, again, this race is not about me. And I think we all heard, I think it was 2 weeks ago, Standard & Poor's lowered our rating for America from stable to negative. And they did that because they said, we're not going to see any change in the next 2 years. If we're not going to see change in the next 2 years, and I hope we do, but if we're not, we need to make sure that it's clear that people understand what those options are when they go to the polls next fall, so we get that change immediately after the next election.
It's looking like it might be a crowded convention. What are a couple of differences between you and the other announced candidate, Brian Paul?
Well, again, our focus is really to build a grassroots effort, and you know, I think an active convention is great. It's good to bring a lot of people together, and I think it makes for a better party and a better campaign. So I'm looking forward to that. Well, I'll leave that up to you. I mean, our focus is really on getting this message out. Our focus is on building this team, and our focus is getting America back on track.
You mentioned the need to repeal health care reform. I know that was obviously an issue last year, and I think one of the questions I asked you last year as well was, is there a replacement in the works? A year later, is there a replacement in the works in Congress, or is it just a need to repeal it?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, starting in January, there were several committees that are working on an alternative to the health care bill. I mean, it's not just one deal. It's a combination of things, but really it's to empower people, having them control the choices and not having government take it over and control the choices.
Fargo's just picking up the last of the sandbags, and the diversion, of course, is on the table. Is there money for close to $2 billion now in this diversion project? What are your thoughts on federal money for the Red River diversion?
Again, it's just like we've done in North Dakota. I mean, quite frankly, we need to fund our priorities. I'm a strong supporter of diversion. I mean, this is something that has a terribly negative impact in our economy, and we need to focus on that. But again, on the national level, we need to focus on priorities and not earmarks.
Do you think it'll be built?
I do.
How do you keep it on the radar with the Mississippi flooding that's taking place now?
Well, again, all these things are not negatives, they're positives. As more and more congressmen and senators are aware of the damage and flooding, I think you get better ideas and more solutions that come out on how to address it. So, again, I've been in discussions with many of my counterparts that both got hit by the tornadoes as well as the flooding, and again, they understand the need to address this. I mean, one of the challenges, of course, flood insurance is expiring in September. And so there's many of these issues that, again, as they become more national, I think it helps us with what we need to do here.
2012 is going to be a farm bill year. How do you see the farm bill differing in the next version compared to what it is now, especially since Speaker Boehner isn't a big fan of the farm bill?
Well, again, I mean, Speaker Boehner, one of the things that he's done is he's empowered the process to weigh in and empowers the committees. Certainly, Lucas, the chairman of the House, I think the farm bill is going to probably originate in the Senate, start in the Senate and come over. You know, the focus we need to have, obviously, agriculture is important here. That's why we're here today in part. I think the farm bill is going to be very good for North Dakota and very good for agriculture. I think the key for agriculture, again, is encouraging our foreign markets And as we do that, some of the safety nets, we won't need them if we have a strong market and strong yields.
Are you saying
last question.
Are you saying there's no more change needed in the house, that everything that needs to be done has been done so far?
No, absolutely not. But everything the House is doing is stalled at the Senate doorstep. And again, this is, for some reason, this message is not getting through the Senate. We need to reduce spending. We need a smaller government. We need to encourage employment. We need to encourage jobs. We need to encourage America. It's not about government jobs. It's about the private sector jobs that we need to roll forward with. And so that therein lies the problem.
What makes you think you'll have a better impact in the Senate than in the House?
Well, I mean, again, the challenge is this has to be fixed. I mean, we need the Senate on board. We need to have a majority in the Senate that understands how to create jobs, understands the private sector, and controls the federal spending. And again, I think that's what's key. Obviously, the House and Senate are going to have to work together as well once we move on. So, again, I want to thank everyone for all your help.